My name is Peter Jacobs, and I teach in geography, geology, and environmental science. Turning Point is a live polling system that you can use to quiz students, to do demographics, or just answer some basic polls, yes, no, inside, outside, whatever sorts of question that you might want to use to stimulate discussion in the class. In particular, I wanted to replace quizzes in a large lecture class where I used to have, they would come up as pop quizzes, students were to rip out a sheet of paper, answer these questions, and turn them in. We often have upwards of 120 students in that class, and they use pieces of paper that are this small to great big pieces. They leave the frilly edges on there, and it was just a headache to go through, grade them, sort them, alphabetize them, get them recorded into the D2L gradebook. And I thought something that would automate this might really help. And after talking with some other faculty that were using Turning Point, or clickers in general, whether it was Poll Everywhere or Turning Point specifically, I thought we'd give it a try. It was interesting. It did speed up the grading aspect of these quizzes because it was recorded automatically. However, it slowed me down in other technological aspects. Okay, so my overall impression is that it was easy to use. There were frustrations getting students registered, and then there were some frustrations that came out of this whole registration process of getting the grades to be recorded in the Turning Point system so then I could integrate with D2L. Primarily used it for live multiple choice quizzes. I also used it for some demographics. For instance, we have a unit in the course. The course is physical geography. We're talking about water resources, and I talk about on-site waste disposal in particular. And I just do a poll to compare it with statewide numbers. The number of students, households in the state is generally about 30% that rely on on-site waste disposal. So I thought I'll ask the class. And so we did a poll. And it was fun. And it actually, I don't know if it stimulates much discussion as much as it just sort of engages the students a little bit more. And in terms of a specific instance, the typical day would be we've been through some lecture material and the pop quiz would come up, and basically I wanted them to be able to see if they were following along with what I was saying. Are the notes they're taking adequate to be able to answer these test questions? And these test questions, the pop quiz questions, that is, were literally taken from my exams. Somebody's phone was always dead. They didn't have their phone out. 90% of them, if not 95, had their phones out anyway. And they would have signed up because I put the registration number for that session ID number, I guess it was, on the board. So mostly they were set up, but there was always somebody that came in late that hadn't done it. And I would recommend instructors try it, especially if they can do a pilot that's not going to cost the students money. It does speed up the initial grading, it does generate some discussion, and it's just kind of fun. It's high tech as opposed to taking out a sheet of paper to scribble some letters down on. Students that had not paid attention to their grade book along the way suddenly came out of the woodwork saying, "I was there that day, but I didn't get any points." And the problem with my class is there were 120 students registered, 119 I think we ended up with. And on a typical day, there would be over 100, 101, 105, something like that. And I didn't know everyone's face. And 3 weeks later, I couldn't tell you if that person had been there. So then I was stuck with this dilemma of, were they really there? Was there a problem with the technology? In the end, my solution was, well, bring me your notes. And this was literally finals week when all of a sudden these emails are coming out of the woodwork. I didn't get my points. I said, bring me your notes. Surely you wrote something down that day. No one ever brought their notes. that tells me something, you know. Having a class that's large and doing this is why we did it, was to try and automate things and make it easier. But it also creates this dilemma where students can try and game the system. And instructors need to be wary of that.